Cantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Dating Essentials for Men, The Only Dating Guide You Will Ever Need, by Dr. Robert Glover. Narrated by Dr. Robert Glover. Introduction. Dating Essentials for Men. Are you a bad dater? If so, welcome to the club. So was I, and so are most of the men walking the planet. Dating and courting are not in our human DNA. They've only existed in Western culture for a few generations. In the East, not even there yet. For most of modern civilization, marriages were arranged by family and clan. The idea of romantic love has only been around a couple of hundred years. Nevertheless, we live in a world where dating skills are essential for finding companionship, love, a mate, and, of course, sexual partners. I find that many men struggle at the most basic aspects of dating and mating. For most of us, these skills don't come naturally, and we've never had someone show us how. Fears of doing something wrong, looking foolish, and getting rejected permeate the minds of most men, regardless of age, physical appearance, and social and economic status. These fears typically manifest in clumsy attempts at approach and/or doing nothing at all. The all-too-common outcome of repeated failures at finding a suitable partner leaves many men feeling defective and unlovable. I've been there. For the majority of my life, I was a loser with the ladies, and I assumed the good women I was interested in just weren't interested in me. But that all changed. Let me tell you about it. When I became single in my mid-40s after 25 years of marriage, I came face to face with the reality that I hadn't dated since college and that I wasn't good at it even then. Back in high school and college, when I wanted to ask a woman out, I would first spend several weeks thinking about her, imagining what it would be like to be with her. My fear, self-limiting beliefs, and lack of skills prevented me from simply approaching her and asking her out. When I finally got up the nerve to approach a woman I'd been obsessing about, I would wait until the last minute, walk up to her awkwardly, and blurt out something like, "I don't guess you would want to go out with me tonight, would you?" She would usually respond with a look of surprise and say something like, "Oh, I already have plans." I would then feel foolish, retreat, and never talk to her again. When I did succeed at getting a girlfriend, I would hang on to her forever because I did not want to repeat the process of having to start dating all over again. As in staying married to two women for 25 years when I never should have dated either more than three times. This time around in my 40s, I realized I would have to learn to do things a lot differently. Here's what I did. I began reading and listening to dating and seduction books and CDs, and drawing from insights I myself had written about in my book, No More Mr. Nice Guy. Then, most importantly, I began applying these principles to see what worked and what did not. I approached dating as if it were a scientific experiment. To my surprise, I found that getting women to talk to me, give me their number, date me, and have sex with me was nowhere nearly as difficult as I thought it would be. In fact, I was often amazed at how simple and easy it could be when applying the right principles. Several of my clients noticed that I was having success meeting women, as well as having lots of sex, and begged me to teach them what I was doing. Out of these requests, Dating Essentials for Men was born. In 2007, I launched four-week online Dating Essentials for Men courses. These courses were a compilation of what I had learned through tons of trial and error and lots of fucking practice. The courses became an instant success because they offered a breath of fresh air from programs that taught men to be cocky funny, spin plates, or run canned pickup routines. This book is an update and expansion of those four courses. If you had asked me any time before the age of 45, if I would be teaching men how to date, I would have said you were crazy. But you know what? If a bad dater like me can learn how to interact confidently with women, get their phone numbers, get laid, and create great relationships, so can you. In my quest to become an effective dater, I discovered many principles that work and many that don't. A lot of what I teach in Dating Essentials for Men is counterintuitive to what you might believe to be true about women, dating, and sex. That's the beauty of the Dating Essentials for Men approach. Most men make dating way too difficult. One of the most common reactions men have to what I present is, "This is easy. I can do this." Dating Essentials for Men makes dating doable, the way it should be. The principles and practices that I share will challenge you in ways that you've never been challenged before. But showing you how simple it is to talk to women, get their phone numbers, date them, and get them into bed increases the likelihood that you will actually get out there and do it. Rest assured, I will not turn you into a geek with techniques, i.e., a man who's memorized 32 openers for working sets, building rapport, or getting a number close, yet who's still terrified of women and lacking basic social skills. The principles I teach and the tools I share in Dating Essentials for Men have helped transform countless bad daters into dating machines. All of these men have been guys just like you and me, most with a history of dating failures and tons of insecurities and self-limiting beliefs. Dating may not be a part of our human DNA, but when you know what you are doing and what works, it truly is easy and doable. What to expect from Dating Essentials for Men. I found that most guys who purchase my Dating Essentials for Men products, classes, workshops, podcasts, etc., fall into one of two categories. Men who have never dated well, have had few real girlfriends, and have had little or no sex. Or men who have recently gotten out of a long-term relationship and are back out in the dating world for the first time in several years. Occasionally, men sign up for my programs because they have been relatively successful with meeting women and dating, but want to improve their skills and attitudes. Regardless of your category, the principles I teach will work for you. Whether you are wanting to learn and practice basic dating skills, develop confidence, get great sex, or meet the woman of your dreams, Dating Essentials for Men will get you moving in the right direction and bring you proven results. Dating Essentials for Men will help you clearly identify your goals for dating and achieve them. Face your fears and soothe your anxiety. Learn new, effective skills for dating, mating, and breaking up. Challenge yourself to act and practice these new skills. Dating Essentials for Men focuses on two core areas of dating. Mastering your mind. The MYM parts of Dating Essentials for Men will help you become aware of and challenge the faults and self-limiting beliefs that keep you stuck at home by yourself every weekend. Perfecting your practice. The PYP parts of Dating Essentials for Men will focus on learning new skills and developing new daily routines that will help you meet and talk to women and get what you want in love and sex. Dating Essentials for Men will go after every distorted belief you have about yourself and dating and challenge you to get out of your comfort zone and find out how easy it is to meet and date lots of great women. It doesn't matter if you want to date for practice, discover your really great woman, or find a friend with benefits. Dating Essentials for Men will teach you how. Making miracles. I want to challenge you to bring your A game to this material. Just purchasing it and leaving it on your computer or phone won't change a goddamn thing in your life. There is no substitute for putting the principles of dating essentials for men into practice. Don't try to figure out how to do it right. Just get out there and do something, and then get out there and do it some more. It works if you work it. Relationships usually result from unexpected miracles, and miracles usually happen around people. Not many miracles happen when you're sitting at home playing Xbox, watching television, or surfing the internet for porn. And not many miracles happen when you're spending 60 to 70 hours a week at work. You have to get out of the house and apply the principles presented in Dating Essentials for Men to make your miracles. Doing this will be scary, but the moment you face your monster, you will be transformed. Here is what I constantly tell men. Get out of the house. Expand your route. Linger in public. Talk to people everywhere you go. Test for interest. Walk through open doors. In reality, Dating Essentials for Men is about expanding your social and emotional intelligence. I just use men's desire to get laid and find love as a motivation for helping them grow up and become interesting people. As you practice the skills I teach in Dating Essentials for Men, you will also be working on the following essential life skills. Becoming aware of and confronting self-limiting beliefs. Stretching yourself and getting out of your comfort zone. Letting go of attachment to outcome. Setting the tone and taking the lead. Getting to rejection quickly. Becoming a good ender. Not only will DEFM help you get the love and sex you want, it will help you become a more complete, confident person. Here's a little secret. When I transformed my love life using the skills I teach in Dating Essentials for Men, I also transformed every other part of my life. My income shot up, many unexpected adventures came my way, my business grew, I made new friends. My overall satisfaction in life multiplied. Are you ready to join the thousands of men who have successfully transformed their dating and love lives? If so, make the investment in yourself. I guarantee it, you'll love the new you. Part 1. Mastering your mind. Most men's dating struggles have very little to do with the reasons they think. I've heard all the justifications, excuses. I'm too short. I'm not experienced enough. I'm boring. Women can see right through me. All women are gold diggers. They only want the tall guys with money. I come too quickly. I can't get or stay hard. I have a small dick. I have social anxiety. I'm introverted. I don't know where to start. I'm afraid of looking foolish. I'm afraid of getting beat up. The women I'm interested in aren't interested in me. All the good women are in a relationship. Blah, blah, blah. Wah, wah, wah. As I said, I've heard them all and even believed a few myself. No matter how strongly you believe these excuses to be true, and no matter how much evidence you can dredge up to support your beliefs, they are lies. They are lies your mind tells you, and they are lies you are happy to believe. Why? Because they let you off the hook. Here's the deal. To successfully date, get laid, and have great relationships, you have to challenge yourself. You have to be willing to face your fears and leave your comfort zone. All of the above beliefs keep you safe. They keep you in the nursery where everything is cozy, safe, and warm. Dating Essentials for Men will show you the way out of the nursery and out into the world of bold masculinity. Practicing what I will teach you in this book will grow you as a man and give you a roadmap for finding the love and sex you want. We will begin with the problem between your ears, your self-limiting beliefs. SLBs, as I call them. The false beliefs that prevent you from getting what you want in all areas of life. The Mastering Your Mind section of Dating Essentials for Men will not only challenge the validity of all of your SLBs, but will completely blow them out of the water. Ready? Let's dive in. Chapter 1. Blast the lies your mind tells you about yourself and women. The world we have created is a product of our thinking. It cannot change without changing our thinking. Albert Einstein. Believe it or not, your mind lies to you all the time. The genius, Albert Einstein, understood this. The biggest lies your mind tells you are usually about yourself and women. This chapter is going to help you identify these lies, understand the effect of them, and then blast them away so you can start getting what you want in love, sex, and relationships. Sound good? Bad daters. Most bad daters, BDs as I call them, struggle with three fundamental problems. Isolation. Bad daters tend to avoid social situations where they might have to talk to people whom they don't know. BDs often suffer from some degree of social anxiety. This is especially pronounced around desirable women. To reduce their anxiety, BDs tend to keep to themselves and take few social risks. Lack of skills. Most bad daters have never acquired the fundamental skills of dating, mating, and breaking up. This is understandable. In many cultures, there is no custom of dating. Even in Western society where there is some history of courtship, it has only existed for a half century or so. The whole idea of romantic love has only existed for a couple of hundred years. If you lack basic dating skills, you are not alone. Most men have never learned how to banter, flirt, test, close the deal, or break up with a woman. This often results in a general lack of confidence. Consequently, BDs tend to avoid women or become a girlfriend with a penis with women whom they desire, hoping this will eventually lead to deeper intimacy. Self-limiting beliefs. Most bad daters struggle with issues of self-acceptance and confidence. This lack of self-esteem is the result of self-limiting beliefs, SLBs. Bad daters tend to be riddled with SLBs. They typically believe that women can tell they are losers just by looking at them. They are consumed with negative self-messages. I'm too fat, I'm inexperienced, I can't handle rejection. Why would a good woman want me? I don't have much sexual experience. I'm boring. All the good women are taken. For bad daters, self-limiting beliefs, i.e. the lies their minds tell them, become self-perpetuating realities that keep them stuck and frustrated. The lessons in the MYM section of Dating Essentials for Men will focus on uncovering and overcoming your self-limiting beliefs about yourself, women, and the world in general. These lessons will probably cause tremendous inner turmoil for you because they will challenge everything you believe to be true. Your mind has been telling you unsubstantiated lies about yourself, women, and the world for most of your life. We are going to challenge these lies. This will make you anxious because your mind believes what your mind tells you to be true. Your mind has been lying to you for years, but you've had no reason to be suspicious of this insidious inner deceit. As we uncover these lies and shine the bright light of reality on them, your mind will go into overdrive to hang on to what it knows to be true. As you experience this inner mental struggle, your mind will try and convince you to keep believing what you have always accepted to be true. This is normal. Just remember, historically, your best thinking has gotten you exactly where you are right now, lonely and frustrated. When it comes to how you view yourself, women, and dating, we are going to be suspicious of everything your mind has believed to be true. As you listen to this book, your brain will frequently shout things like, "Bullshit! That's not true. I can't do that. Women aren't like that. If I did that, I'd get slapped. That might work for other guys, but it won't work for me." Whenever you hear these voices in your head, pay attention to them and state them out loud. Yes, actually, say them out loud. This chapter will help you explore, become conscious of, and overcome the lies that prevent you from approaching women, talking to them, asking for their phone number, taking them out, getting them into bed, and creating long-term, loving relationships. The following chapters will build on this process. This information will blast your SLBs out of your mind and help you start getting what you want in love, sex, and relationships. What gets us into trouble is not what we don't know, is what we know for sure that just ain't so. Mark Twain. Toxic Shame. In No More Mr. Nice Guy, I discuss the effects of toxic shame as it relates to the nice guy syndrome. Toxic shame is the deeply held, unconscious belief that you are bad, defective, or unlovable. It is the result of the inaccurate internalization of life's events from birth on. When you experienced neglect, abandonment, inconsistent nurturing, smothering, or emotional, verbal, or physical abuse as a child, you inaccurately internalized that you were the cause. You believed there must be something wrong with you that caused the painful things you were experiencing. What makes these early life experiences so debilitating is that the events and the interpretation of the events were stored up in a part of your brain that has no language or reasoning capability. The first part of your brain that developed as a child is called the amygdala. It is often referred to as the primal brain. It is the source of the fight, flight, freeze mechanism. As stated above, this emotional storehouse of your mind does not have language or reasoning capability. It operates on a purely primal survival basis. The cortex, the reasoning and language part of your brain, developed later and more slowly. It was just getting going around the age of 4 or 5 and did not fully develop until you were around 25. That is why young men's auto insurance rates are so high. The part of the brain responsible for making good decisions isn't fully developed in men until their mid-20s. This means that everything that happened to you in the first few years of your life was stored up in the emotional part of your brain, not the reasoning part. The internalization of early life's events, along with heredity, your inherited temperament, goes a long way in determining how you interpret your early life experiences, determines your emotional personality. The thinking part of your brain accepts without question everything recorded in the emotional centers of your brain to be 100% accurate. These emotional beliefs are the DOS of your mental operating system. They are your machine language. Your thinking and reasoning rises out of and reflects your unconscious emotional paradigm. Your mind will always work to make sure your mental beliefs are consistent with the nonverbal emotional beliefs you internalized as a young child. Even though toxic shame is a purely emotional experience, you attach words and thoughts to this deep, uncomfortable feeling. You might say you feel lonely, isolated, anxious, fearful, bad, or unloved. You then attach personal meaning to these feelings. I feel depressed because no one likes me. I'm lonely because I'm not good enough. When people find out how defective I really am, they all leave me. If I was taller, thinner, smarter, more outgoing, richer, etc., etc., then I wouldn't feel so lonely. Since every human being grows up in an imperfect family and in an imperfect world, everyone internalizes some degree of toxic shame in childhood. As you grew into adolescence and adulthood, you continued to add evidence from life's events that seemed to support the emotional beliefs you internalized at a young age. This is called the paradigm effect. The paradigm effect. Here is how paradigms work. Information that seems to support your self-limiting beliefs will be sought out, amplified, and retained as evidence of the accuracy of your SLBs. Information that seems to contradict or challenge the validity of your SLBs will not be noticed, will be minimized, or rationalized away. Here is an example. If an attractive woman smiles at you or talks to you, you assume that she is just being polite or smiling at someone else because such behavior contradicts your SLBs. The cycle then repeats itself over and over again. Your SLBs, resulting from toxic shame, have their greatest impact on your personal relationships. If you believe that you are defective and unlovable, you will assume that everyone else sees you the same way. Why would you ask a woman out if you are convinced you are defective and she will soon see this and reject you? Why would you let people know you deeply if they are just going to find out how imperfect you are? Due to toxic shame, your self-limiting beliefs convince you that attractive women are not attracted to you. Therefore, because you believe this to be true, you don't interact with women you find attractive. Therefore, because you don't interact with attractive women, they tend not to notice you or interact with you. Therefore, you then use this data to reinforce the belief that attractive women aren't interested in you, which of course means you continue to avoid interacting with them. How self-limiting beliefs affect dating. The self-limiting beliefs attached to your toxic shame are the number one problem hindering you from getting what you want in love, sex, and relationships. Here are some of the ways your SLBs affect your dating. How you think is how you are. What you think about and believe to be true is what you will create. Your mindset will determine how you interact with women and how they respond to you. If you are telling yourself, "I'm a worthless piece of shit," how do you think you will approach women, if at all? And how do you think they will respond to you? If you are telling yourself, "I'm an interesting, great guy and women really like me," how do you think you will approach women and how do you think they will respond to you? SLBs quietly encourage you to isolate and avoid. Most of the time, you aren't aware of your SLBs because they whisper in the back of your consciousness. Just stay home tonight. Oh, don't talk to her. She wouldn't be interested. Go ahead and stay on the internet a little longer. Don't make eye contact. She'll think you're a pervert. It isn't until you consciously put yourself into a situation that challenges your self-limiting beliefs or an unexpected opportunity presents itself that these voices shout louder in your conscious mind. Are you crazy? What the hell do you think you are doing? If you talk to her, she'll just reject you and you'll look like a fool. Look down now. Keep on walking. Phew, that was close. You're such a loser. You'll never have a woman like her. Don't even think about it. When it is all over, you tell yourself, "See, attractive women never talk to me." it becomes a self-reinforcing cycle. Self-limiting beliefs create negative emotions. Not only do SLBs get in the way of you taking action, they also create negative emotional states. If your mind keeps telling you that you have low self-esteem, that you aren't attractive, or that you're a lousy lover, you will naturally feel bad. In addition, because your SLBs prevent you from taking actions that would improve your life, you become even further depressed. Because it feels normal for you to feel bad, and because feeling bad reinforces your SLBs, a vicious cycle is perpetuated throughout your life. SLBs cause you to date down, settle, and stay too long in bad relationships. Because of your SLBs, you probably date down and settle for women whom you don't enjoy or who don't turn you on. Your SLBs have probably caused you to stay in bad or unfulfilling relationships way too long because you don't think there are many good women out there. Even if there were, you don't believe you could ever get one. You might as well stay right where you are. SLBs prevent you from seeing and walking through open doors. Due to self-limiting beliefs, you don't walk through open doors or take advantage of opportunities presented to you. Raise your hand if you've had a chance to date or sleep with a woman you desired but didn't take advantage of the opportunity when it presented itself because of your SLBs. Your self-limiting beliefs keep you safe. Jeremy had been in one of my groups for single men for several months. In his late 30s, he was smart, funny, and athletic. He had a great job and condo. He had only been in two short-term relationships in his life. Even though he came to group regularly and talked about dating, he never put any real effort into actually applying what he was learning. During a discussion of self-limiting beliefs, I asked Jeremy what he was afraid a woman would find out about him if she really got to know him. He listed two or three things that he was sure would cause any woman to reject him if she got to know him well enough. I asked him how he knew this to be true. His response was that the two women he had dated had both broken up with him. He took that as proof that all women would find him defective and leave him. Jeremy's SLBs were obviously there to keep him safe. If he didn't risk, he wouldn't get hurt. When I challenged the validity of his beliefs, he hung on tightly to the fact that since he was batting 1,000 in the rejection department, there must be something wrong with him. His mind completely tuned out the possibility that these women might have been insecure or dysfunctional themselves, and that an N of 2 wouldn't stand up in any research study. He had a science background. Nevertheless, Jeremy continued to hang on tightly to beliefs that kept him feeling safe. Challenge your beliefs. A belief is a thought you keep thinking. Your mind believes your beliefs are true because you have always thought them. Because your mind strives for consistency, it finds plenty of evidence to support your beliefs and ignores information that is contradictory. Many of your beliefs about yourself, women, and sex are not necessarily true or accurate, but your mind believes them because it has repeatedly thought them. For example, a client of mine lamented that he'd given up hope of finding any woman who might be his really great woman, RGW. He told me that he didn't find many women all that interesting. The few women he did find to be interesting were married or in a relationship. He stated that he'd given up ever finding the kind of woman he would really want to get involved with. How do you think this belief system was playing out in his life? I suggested to my client that what he believed to be true would become true. As long as his mind kept telling him that all the good women are taken, he would be sure and never find one. I suggested that he start repeating the following mantra to himself several times a day. In the next 30 days, I am going to meet 3 women who have the potential to be my really great woman. They are available and looking for me. I told him his job was to put himself in a position to meet these women and walk through the open doors. Doing so included challenging his self-limiting beliefs, getting out of the house, talking to people, working on making himself into the kind of man a great woman would be attracted to, and not spending too much time with any woman who didn't have the potential to be his RGW. After just a week or two, my client told me that repeating this mantra made him more optimistic. He had started noticing and interacting with a number of really interesting women. He began approaching women whom he thought might be one of these 3 women because he hated to miss an opportunity. He found that he was in a consistently better mood and taking better care of himself. He ended an on-and-off-again relationship with a woman he'd been involved with for a couple of years. Within 3 months of repeating this mantra regularly to himself, a mutual friend introduced him to a woman who matched every quality he had been looking for. This woman was intelligent, stable, active, attractive, and available. He reported that he never would have found such a great match if he hadn't worked on changing his negative, deprivation-based way of thinking. He also realized that even if this relationship didn't work out, it was still proof that great women are out there. Chapter 2. The Joy of Dating. Uncover and overcome your self-limiting beliefs. Your mind believes what your mind tells itself is true, and it is wrong more often than not. Dating activates your self-limiting beliefs, SLBs, like nothing else. This is good news. SLBs affect every part of your life and keep you stuck and unhappy. By challenging your self-limiting beliefs through the process of dating, you can clear these mental lies out and start experiencing all kinds of great things in life. Think for a moment what dating really is. When you decide to date, what you are really deciding to do is present yourself to the women of the world and ask them the following question. In spite of all of my visible flaws, and all the ones you can't see yet, but which I'm painfully aware of, do you find me interesting enough to talk to me, give me a phone number, go out with me, sleep with me, and maybe become my girlfriend? If this doesn't bring up every one of your self-limiting beliefs, I don't know what will. Dating can trigger your inner shame and make you believe you are totally worthless like nothing else can. In Dating Essentials for Men, I suggest we look at dating in a whole new light. Don't look at dating as an attempt to get women to like you, sleep with you, marry you, etc. Look at dating as the most effective way imaginable to clean out all the distorted mental crap you've been packing around inside you since birth. The bonus is that you will also get the love and sex you've been looking for. Here's what I personally discovered after applying the dating principles I'm teaching you in this book. Not only was I going on plenty of dates and having lots of sex, but I was also experiencing amazing success in every other area of my life. Work, money, friendship, etc. My business took off. I started making more money than I ever had before in my life. Personal and social opportunities presented themselves to me right and left. All of these things happened because dating helped me uncover my latent SLBs and overcome them. Types of self-limiting beliefs. When it comes to dating, self-limiting beliefs can take many different forms and occur in many different situations. there are the SLBs that lead to inactivity. Because you don't believe you are attractive or desirable, you pretty much keep to yourself and don't talk to women. Other self-limiting beliefs pop up when you are actually presented with an opportunity. She smiled at me and said hello. Should I talk to her? What should I say? I'll probably just say something stupid. Maybe I misinterpret her friendliness. What if I make a fool of myself? What if everyone sees? I'm just not good at this. I'll just get my coffee and leave. Then there are the SLBs that repeat themselves in your mind after a missed opportunity. Why did I freeze up? I'm such a loser. She seemed to like me, but I never get it right. I'll never have a girlfriend. Why try? I'm worthless. You can have self-limiting beliefs about every aspect of dating. These include beliefs about you, about a particular woman, women in general, sex, and about the world. About you. I'm too fat, poor, shy, etc. I'm not rich, tall, young, etc. Attractive women don't talk to me. I'm a loser. About a particular woman. She is so pretty. She probably has a boyfriend. She would only date a really successful guy. About women in general. Women have all the control. All women want a successful man. Women don't like sex. All the good women are taken. About sex. I'm a bad man if I want sex. I don't believe I can satisfy a woman. Women think men who want sex are bad. About the world. Good things happen to other people, not me. There's only so much to go around. It's only a matter of time until the other shoe drops. Becoming aware of self-limiting beliefs. Often in my seminars, I have the guys take turns being the class secretary and writing down class members' SLBs as they come up. It is amazing how these self-limiting beliefs just pop out of guys' mouths without them ever even being aware of them. I point them out and request the SLB secretary write them down. Here are some of the ones that come up frequently. A woman will think I'm hitting on her. People will think I'm a dirty old man. Women will think I'm sleazy. Women will think I'm a serial killer. I might get rejected. I might be intruding. I don't deserve a loving relationship. I'm not good with small talk. I won't have anything interesting to say. I might fail. I don't want to come on too strong. What if she is in a relationship? I don't want to be phony or fake. I can't see myself doing it. I might make a fool of myself. I might piss a woman off. She will tell all her friends if I make a fool of myself. I don't want to be a jerk. I'll have to give up too much to be in a relationship. I don't want women to think I'm a player. I have low self-esteem. It is easier for other people than it is for me. I'm shy. I lack confidence. Do any of these internal sound bites sound familiar? Emotionally laden language. Another way to become aware of your SLBs is to pay attention to your emotionally laden language. When nice guys and bad daters talk about their experience with women and dating, they often use strong emotional terms that reveal their self-limiting beliefs. I have to point these words and phrases out to them because they don't usually realize how much negative energy they project into these situations. This negative energy is just one more manifestation.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.